Welcome everyone, my name is Alexos Zakis and today I will be presenting multi-attribute similarity sets for interactive data exploration. This is a project done by Kostas Patroubas, Alexos Zakis and Dimitrios Koutas from Athena Research Center in Greece and Roberto Santoro from Spaziodati SRL in Italy. What is SimSearch? SimSearch is an open source software for searching for similar entities based on multiple attributes of different types, numerical, spatial and textual. Why do you use SimSearch? Each result is ranked according to their overall similarity to the query entity, while no user-specified threshold is required. In contrast, in fasted search, we rely on Boolean filters with user-defined value ranges, and that may return too many or too few results. Also, we retrieve and compare results of different weight combinations, and we offer various visualizations for inspection and comparison of the results. For example, if the user wants to find comments that are related to hotel, food, and tourism, have a revenue of 1 million euros and are located in or close to Florence, in our approach, we retrieve the nearest neighbor per attribute, and then we aggregate the results to obtain the final ranking. This is an overview of our system. We have three main components, the data manager, the query engine, and the user interface, which communicate and exchange data. The data manager keeps track of the available data sources and queryable attributes. This can be either ingested, we construct in memory indices. For example, for numerical attributes, we have a B+tree. For set value textual, we have an inverted index. And for spatial, we have an R-tree. Attributes can also be queried in situ with appropriate connectors. For example, for a PostgreSQL database, we have a JDBC connector. For an Elasticsearch index, we use the REST API. In the query engine, we use as input the user's preference settings. This can be the attributes to use, different weight combinations, number of results, and the appropriate rank aggregation algorithm. And there are two main steps. First, we retrieve a separate rank list for each attribute. This can be done in parallel. And then we perform a rank aggregation to combine all of these lists. Finally, we return a final rank list of results. Now, per attribute, we retrieve a ranked list of M results. To be noted, attributes of a single dataset can be located in different sources. The size M should be much larger than K to have a sufficiently large pool of partial results to aggregate. Each list is ordered by using an appropriate distance measure for each attribute type. For textual data, we use the Jaccard distance. For spatial, we use the Euclidean, and so on. We then normalize by the kth neighbor distance to make scores comparable across lists. Finally, we apply an exponential decay function to obtain the ranking score in the interval 0-1. Then we have to aggregate all these lists in the final list. If all attributes are available for random access, we use the threshold algorithm. This is faster and yields greater scores. Otherwise, we perform the no random access. It maintains lower and upper bounds for scores, and it may yield approximate scores. If some attributes are local, we suggest and perform the partial random access. It also maintains a lower and upper bound for scores, but it is updated with local information for better accuracy. There is also a fourth option that we are currently working on to implement and integrate a pivot-based multimetric indexing mechanism. This can all be found in the bibliography below. Finally, we have the user interface, where the user can search for a specific company by name to use as a query or manually insert values. And she can also experiment with different weight combinations to favor some of the attributes. In the output, we have tables of the final ranked lists per weight combination. We have statistics on correlations within and across result lists. And we offer the visualizations of results per attribute. We have histograms and box plots for numerical, word clouds and top K histograms for textual, and maps for spatial. Finally, in the demonstration that we are about to show you, we have deployed a service over the Atoka knowledge base provided by Spaziodati. There are almost 6 million companies in Italy active in 2019. The data are accessible in different modes. They are ingested in memory and are queried in situ from a PostgreSQL database, from an Elasticsearch index, and another SimSearch instance. And there are four attributes, the revenue and employees, which are numerical, the keywords, which are set values textual, and the location, which is spatial.
Okay,
This is the live demonstration of SimSearch, and this is the starting screen. The URL is public, but you have to provide for a valid API key in order for it to work. So here in the advanced settings, these are some of the settings for the algorithm, the K, the decay factor, and the rank aggregation algorithm. So we paste here the API key and click save. There are two ways to search for the company, either by name here in the search bar and have some suggestions and choose one, or we can manually insert values here. So we are going to search for a specific company. Click search, and the values will be auto-filled. We are going to use the revenue, location, and keywords, and we're going to use four different weight combinations. We want to omit employees, so there are two ways to do that. We can either reduce the weight to zero, or we can erase the value, and this will be automatically disregarded. So in the first weight combination, we are going to emphasize all of the attributes, and in the other three weight combinations, we are going to emphasize only one. So here we are going to emphasize revenue, here we are going to emphasize location, and here keywords. And we click submit. This can take a few seconds. Keep in mind that if we use all of the attributes and many weight combinations, this is heavier for the computation. Also, to be noted that when you emphasize only one of the attributes, you expect the results to be centered around that value. For example, here in the second weight combination that we ask for the revenue to be emphasized, we expect the resulting companies to have similar revenue. While in the other two, we hold it of lesser significance. The same goes for location. For example, we want here we expect comments that will be centered, that will be in the center of Florence. These are the appropriate coordinates. And in the other two weight combination, they will be scattered throughout Italy. And the same goes for keywords. In the first tab, we can see the resulting companies for each of the weight combinations. For example, here for the first weight combination, we can see that all of the scores are high. While if you choose the second weight combination where we emphasized on the revenue, we can search here, for example, in the seventh row, we can see that the location score is 0.48. We can also save each of the ranked lists. In the second tab, which is called statistics, we're going to measure the quality of the ranked lists. In the first part, we are going to see how similar are the records inside the ranking list. Here, for example, the first weight combination, we emphasized all of the attributes, so we expect to be similar. While in the other three weight combination, we only emphasized one attribute at a time, and the other two would have a higher variance. So this is why in the first similarity metrics, we have lighter colors, and in the other three, we have darker colors, because the resulting entities are not similar inside the ranked list. In the second part, we see how different each ranked list is from the other in pairs, with three known correlation coefficients: the Pearson, the Spearman correlation, and the Kendall correlation. So in the third tab, we're going to see visualization for each of the attributes. First, there are the numerical ones. Here's revenue. As expected, in the second weight combination that we focused on the revenue, we see a distribution around the 1 million euros. And in the first weight combination as well, but with a few outliers in the far right and the far left. In the other two weight combination, we can see that there are many outliers, and in the third weight combination, no distribution at all. This is much clearer in the box plot, where here it is clear that this is the desired outcome, and not in the other weight combinations. Next, we have the location. Here, as expected, again, in the third weight combination, we have companies in the center of Florence, and in the other weight combination, they are scattered throughout Italy. For example, here, in the second weight combination, we have 21 companies in Florence, but 11 companies in the north of Italy. The second plot is a heat map. We use the similarity score as the value. And again, we can see that they are clustered in the center of Florence in the third weight combination and in the fourth as well, in the wider area of Florence, but the other ones are scattered throughout Italy. Finally, we have the clustered old clouds, where we have clustered the companies in smaller clusters. For example, here we can see that they have the most frequent keywords inside that cluster are restaurant, food, hotel, etc. But in this cluster, we have other frequent keywords as well that are marketing, trade, and others. Finally, we have plots for keywords. We have the word clouds. But keep in mind that we used a big set of keywords, so there are a lot of frequent words as well. But it's clear that there are some that are dominant in each weight combination, like a restaurant, food, hotel, and that is much clearer in the top 10 histogram, where we have food, hotel, and restaurant in the dominant. So that is the end of my presentation. Thank you all for your attention, and I'm looking forward to answering your questions.